I knew going in there. Oh, by the way, I keep having to tell this story. Going into the Apple Store, this is the first, hardware device I've purchased in an Apple Store. Predominantly Amazon now has to pay state tax, so, it's like, all right, whatever.
Screw it,
so,
you'll go stand in line with the Britney Spears wannabes.
So she wanted a kind of, she wanted that instantaneous joy thing, so. I went to the Apple Store, it was funny. I go in there, let me tell you though, Apple's got their game on in the retail store. Number one, the store's freaking packed. I have no idea why, but the damn thing is packed. Whatever, people are going to... I guess it's the place to go. It's obvious it's where this is the cool thing. I mean, people are just everywhere in that store.
Okay, Bit, I have to ask you an honest question as a side tier to this story, not to interrupt it. But every time I gravitate by an Apple store, yes, they're always full. But as I half listen to the conversations going on in them, I suddenly feel my IQ dropping.
Well, look, we already established it. The current Apple demographic consumer base is not...
Well, no, I'm asking. Was that your experience, too?
I didn't pause to listen, but here's my experience. I walk in, I get greeted immediately. Hey, how are you doing? I said, great,
I'm a genius. How may I be subservient?
Well, two Apple reps come up to me. I mean, literally, you're they're ready.
Yes, they have you surrounded now.
Yeah, sometimes that's a put off to me, by the way. But in this case, it was good. And I said, look, I just need to get an Apple TV and get out of here. And what was interesting though, in this, I give kudos to the Apple retail training or whatever. One guy comes up, which was not the two people that were originally with me. They seated gracefully, and this one guy comes up, and this other guy who read my lips from the back of the store comes up and says, "I have him for the Apple TV." It was kind of creepy, but man, they were on their game. And so I go there. The guy gets the Apple TV box, asked me if I wanted any, the HDMI thing or what have you. Boom, ready for the sale. They're doing most of the things on the iPhone. They got the old symbol logic, infrared scanners, the UPC symbols on there, the whole shebang. And then we get to the point where he wants my email, and I tell him Mac.com, and the guy's like, "Whoa!" I said, "Yes, I'm old school." And so the guy kind of pauses and stuff, and it was kind of interesting because he was an older gentleman as well. And I said, "Yeah, I've been with Apple products." And I said, "Geez, far back as you can remember, you kind of talked about older, some of the clones and stuff like power computing that we had." And I looked at him, I said, "It's amazing to see where Apple is today versus my memories of going to Sears or always being the underdog and trying to say, hey, look at," and it sparked a very interesting conversation. I said, I told the guy, I said, flat out, I'm not in total agreement with the direction that Apple's going, but I said, to see a store, an Apple store, and if you were to take me several years ago and put that person in this store, it'd be an absolute shock as to how Apple is today versus the way, the old me knew it. And so the guy was like, it was just very nostalgic that we had that conversation. But they were on their game. I got out in and out very quickly, and it was good.
Okay. I'm sorry, the South Park scene is going through my head now of the geniuses having the kumbaya moment.
These were not geniuses. The genius part was full, by the way.
Oh, it's always full. I never asked you on that. What did you think of the Apple Genius advertisements?
I haven't seen any.
What?
I don't watch TV all that often, so...
Dude, they made news. Hold on. Okay,
Bob's still here, and your air conditioner sounds like a jet engine.
I know that, and I can't do anything about it, because I'm not allowed to touch it. Apparently, I'm 5. Bit, open the 823 Grumpy Text.
Okay. There's Have to refresh. I still don't see it from the LB takes 214, 316, 45. It just goes 911, 821, 710, 75, 628.
Okay, screw it. I'll just put it in the dock for today under the Apple section. These damn things.
Let me see this. Wow. So these are new commercials.
Well, they're not so new anymore. The second link, because the first one's a Google one, sorry.
Oops. It says invalid link.
Hold on.
The only weird thing that's happening about this whole thing that's happening, the Apple event that's happening tomorrow, is that the day after that, Nintendo's having an event.
Hold on, before we get into gaming, this I want to get Bit's reaction to these. I can't believe he didn't know they existed.
I didn't really know.
Because he's about as old school Mackian as you can get, and the big complaint about these, I think they're very appropriate for the current Apple demographic, but they really are insulting to users like him.
This video is private.
They've all been taken down?
But, MrBit10, can you guess whose event was named first? Who came out first and whose event came out second? Nintendo's or Apple's?
No.
Nintendo announced their event first, and then Apple came out with it about a few weeks ago.
Apparently they have.
Are you saying that Nintendo's going to one up Apple or something?
It's just weird that Apple is trying to one up Nintendo all of a sudden. I mean, it's just that Nintendo came up with their event first, and then when they said that it was going to come out, and then all of a sudden here's Apple saying, well, here's our event day before.
Here's what I'm seeing. Apple pulls Genius TV ads from YouTube and Apple.
I didn't realize they were being this aggressive with pulling them. Oh, Bit, if you'd seen them, you'd know why they were being aggressive.
Somebody's got to have them somewhere.
I have them. I can email them to you. I have them.
How embarrassed is Apple by the reaction to his Genius TV ads that ran a few weeks back? Not only did it stop airing them on TV, but as of Wednesday, the company has pulled them from its official YouTube channel. What happened with these ads? It's almost like the company wants to make it.
Like the Labor Day one. This guy, his wife's in labor. He wakes up the Apple Genius at 2 in the morning. Instead of trying to take his wife to the hospital, he needs the Genius to tell him he needs to take his wife to the hospital because he needs the Genius's help to figure out how to make an announcement. That this is going on.
Here we go. I found one.
This is your captain. Is there an Apple Genius on board?
I'm a genius.
3D forgot his anniversary. He wants to make his wife an iMovie, but we land in 27 minutes.
Look at all this footage.
It's gonna be okay.
Move this here?
Mm-hmm.
So I just drag in our wedding song?
Yeah, from iTunes.
What if I wanted to add a...
Please turn off all electronic devices.
No, we're not gonna make it.
We're gonna make it. Add the sepia effect. It's very romantic.
And done. Awesome.
We have 2 minutes. 21F is working on a keynote.
Let's go. Let's do this.
Of all of them, it's like, I need the genius to tell me how to live.
Hey, you're a genius, right?
Yes, that's the basically one.
Hey, you're a genius, right?
Yeah.
I basically just got a Mac myself.
But wait, what do you mean basically?
Basically, it looks like a Mac.
Great, it came loaded with all the great apps like iPhoto, iMovie, GarageBand. Not ringing a bell, huh?
No.
Who sold this to you?
He did. Said he's basically an Apple genius.
No.
So this is nothing like a Mac.
Basically no.
Hmm.
Mr. Green, it's 4 a.m.
My wife is having the baby. I need your help.
What can I do?
I want to make a photo card to announce the birth.
Okay. Yeah, you can make letterpress cards with iPhoto. They even have different themes if it's a baby boy or a baby girl. Should I call an ambulance?
Definitely, but what about photo books for the grandparents?
Yeah, really neat coffee table books. And we can talk about all of that on the way to the hospital, okay, Mr. Green?
Mrs. Green, we're coming!
Let me tell you, there is truth to these commercials, by the way. That is a new demographic. I can't tell you. No, like I said, they're very old school Applins,
but really, what the Mac demographic is today, that is their target customer.
We talk about different shit back in our day. I mean, like, Apple back then was very much, you know, productivity and stuff, but this is the... My parents' best friends are very much like this. And Aaron, let me tell you, I'm known as the Apple, whatever. I'm not going to say genius, but I'm the Apple guy that everybody goes to. And it's my parents' friends from everywhere, what have you, how do you do this? And they are asking questions like, how do I make this movie? But the husband of my mom's best friend, at least is productive. He has problems, though, syncing with Exchange and getting the Mac, iPhone, everything to actually sync the mailbox, which is a problem, and I was working with him on that. At least that was something cool to do. But it is true that this is a target.
But apparently Apple can't acknowledge it publicly because
this, I will tell you, these are a lot of Apple customers, man. But you know, I mean, is it that the you know, that's why I can't stand the bubblegum crowd, the whole pop culture crowd. You know, they behave in a certain way, but they don't want to be called on.
Exactly.
You have a certain behavior, but you don't want to be called on. I mean, well, I'm sorry. They're pretty cornball, but I'm looking at, like, the airplane one. Like, well, how do I do this in iMovie? That does hurt a lot. People do buy Macs just to manage. Apple has gotten into people's minds about movie. Which is fine. It's important to people. Let me tell you, photos and all that stuff are priority one for my wife. Photos are everything she loves to do about personal people.
Well, but see, what you're getting at there, and that's why I brought these up, because like the iPhone thing. Apple's oversimplify it thing. These people, they're sitting around all the time going, well, where's the shiny button? Which shiny button? How do I shiny button? Shiny button, shiny button, which shiny button? Tell me the shiny button. Is it shiny button, or shiny button, shiny button?
Mac OS X to me is not. I'm not gonna complain about Mac OS X, but. Definitely iOS.
No. I'm not so much Echo OS 10 why it's not my cup of tea, but I'm referring to, like, they were talking about in the Basically thing, as if the only way you could possibly cut audio files together is with GarageBand.
Sure. Yeah.
What
was it? I saw the other day, I don't want to monopolize it, but I saw this, what was it? It was somebody bitching about Windows. It was in some article, and they were talking about the start button. And I said, you know, Windows is trying to get rid of the start button, and I am a fan of that. I always hated clicking one fucking thing to get the whole picture. You know, and then drilling down, right? And that's why you always see Windows desktops crowded with icons. Point and shoot. And I know we've always discussed Windows 8, and yes, there's going to be problems if they don't fix certain things, but it's still, the tiles are point and shoot. But the home button of the freaking iPhone, and I made that correlation, it was a few weeks back, is the fucking start button. It is the master to do anything and everything on that phone. It's most frustrating. When I use my BlackBerry, or I don't want to bring in WebOS, because WebOS is very gesture, so I don't have to worry about all that, but my BlackBerry and my wife's Razer versus that freaking home button is a joy to use with, you know, several options and what I want to do. Versus the goddamn home button. I'm so sick of that fucking home button. It reminds me of the Windows start button. So, alright.
Okay.
You have a comment, Bob?
Go ahead, Bob.
I would never comment bad about Apple products.
Bullshit.
All I'm going to say is, how can it, I've seen these commercials, if that's your target demographic, how did they get confused with the one shiny fucking button on the goddamn phone?
Well, to be honest with you, Bob, to be honest with you, most people did with the smartphone of before was the BlackBerry. You know, I will bring it up. I'm going to bring this up. I did find it cute that Obama was handing an iPhone and couldn't figure out how to make a phone call. I did find that genius.
Is that a true quote?
No, it's A. Regardless of what I think of as politics, I think that is user behavior that I find in my life. And so many people whose iPhones are limited in their use. They only know how to use so much of it. Versus my wife using this droid razor that's turned it into a freaking carnival circus of whatever the hell she wants it to be. You know what I'm saying? And it's something that I'm just observing, that I'm seeing. And it is a pain in the ass.
Really, it's proving my point with what I've said with Apple. Apple oversimplifies things. They do.
For iOS, for sure. But iOS 10, I'm not going to necessarily agree, but iOS. That's why I abandoned iOS. If they were to do the same thing with iOS 10, God, sadly, most tragically, I either sit on my the latest and greatest iOS 10 version that I can stomach and milk it for as long as it'll last. But if the second iOS 10 becomes that cumbersome, yeah, then it's over, sadly.
Yeah, I hated lying when they started putting that iOS launch pad in there, which pissed me off. And I don't like how they did that whole multi-windows thing where it's all going sideways now, except like the old way. Mm-hmm. Or like, Mission Control's little replacement of, what was it originally?
It was Spaces. Yes.
It was Spaces and
Expose. And the little gadget widget.
I didn't mind if they combined the applications into one onto Mission Control. I hated the fact that they redesigned it.
Yeah, there is an app, I found it, that you can get for a line of selector that will give you the old Spaces.
But I will say...
Yeah, are you ever going to provide the link for that so people don't
kill... I thought I did on the last show.
No?
I swear to God, I thought I gave it to you.
No,
right, but
you were going to.
But I will say, Mountain Lion, they went into some batshit crazy, you know, why the fuck did they put this here, like, Game Center on Mountain Lion? It's completely useless, and, you know, if you want to track your achievements and all that, get Steam.
Alright, it's called Total Spaces, bring back grid spaces to Western Line and more. It's called Total Spaces.
Just put it there under the Apple thing.
Binary Age makes it. This is actually not even the same app that I saw before, so there must be multiple apps. This is not the same one that I saw before, but this is the first one in Google. So there it is.
But okay. I am glad they put Dictator in there. That was a sweet...
You know, I hear a lot of people saying that. They said, if you're on something, yeah. A lot of people that have Mountain Lab are saying, hey, the dictation is great.
Oh, yeah. It doesn't get all your words, but it gets a lot of them.
Mm-hmm.
So basically, y'all can finally do what I've been able to do on Android. I'm glad.
Well, no, all you do is just highlight an area, or, you know, you just put the cursor where you want to say it, and say what you want, and it'll type out that word.
Yeah. You know, I will tell you. Yeah, go ahead, sir. I thought you paused.
But, you know, it's really a great little add-on. Unlike Game Center, which is completely useless.
Okay, is this a good wrapping point, just so I can put a break in the thing?
Well, I'm going to have to go in like 7 minutes, but...
okay,
Russ, you were bringing up a good point. Something that also, you know, Windows is feeling more and more archaic a bit. In terms of, especially like when using Linux more a little bit now.
When have you been using Linux more?
Side developments. I'm not necessarily having to fire them up on my own servers, but I'm helping develop software for these old databases.
Okay.
And Linux is a cheaper solution to port them over. So they're wanting to do this, and I'm making a user interface.
You know, the thing you're bringing up there, it amazes me how many places are seriously looking at using Linux or BSD just because they don't like the direction other things are going, and it's more cost effective to just port it over than to try and keep a legacy proprietary going.
At least with Mountain Lion, it seems to me like they realize trying to combine iOS and make it, you know, the status OS for like everything. And now they're realizing that they got to separate macOS and iOS, which is a better idea because, you know, who wants iOS on their Macs?
Well, the people in the Apple Store. Anyways, what were you saying about development?
No,
never mind.
I was just saying though that Mountain Lion is more going backwards now, away from trying to turn macOS 10 into iOS again. They seem to be diverting away from it.
That means they're killing iOS because they either turn OS 10 into iOS or they have to basically.
No, they can keep them both and separate, but they can't just combine them both. That would be a bad idea. It would bankrupt the company. Ultimately, nobody would want it anymore. I mean, look at Windows. They're unifying theirs, and it's not working. The Slate is a complete failure.
Is the Slate the same thing as a Surface, or is that two different things?
They are two different things. Microsoft is trying to make one platform to rule them all.
I hear that philosophy though, because I don't think that mobile is going to last much longer. I think that computing.
I think the form factors are going to continue to change, and in principle, I agree with the one core to rule them all, which is one of the reasons I like Linux because.
Yeah.
I can stick a different desktop environment on top, and underneath, it's still the same GNU core.
Right.
And there's no reason Microsoft couldn't do something like that, except the way they're going about it is to say, not only do all form factors have to use the exact same UI, but it is against the ULAW for you as a third-party developer to fix this.
Yeah, exactly. I know their UI is becoming extremely cumbersome across form factors. Because what you and I are after is I want the same function. I don't want to pick up maybe a smaller device and then all of a sudden be limited.
Right.
But
because it's a different form factor, I have to access that functionality through a different UI.
I understand. And I do get it. Yeah.
Well, the thing is that people want a computer so they can do whatever they want with it. And the iOS is just basically the mobile version of all that, but with a less form factor, because I don't see this for bit getting on this phone and then programming an entire video game.
Well, if he's going to write it entirely from source code, he could, because it is powerful enough to write and then export it to something else to compile. But the problem is, a UI and a good interface application to do that just doesn't exist at this point in time.
Well, let's put it this way. I'm not going to sit on a very small form factor writing from scratch. But it certainly doesn't hurt to be able to get a phone call, say, I have a bug in the software. Can you fix this?
And fix that line of code or function or whatever.
And do it quickly, easily, and not run into limitations. And at the same time, be able to navigate, because sometimes it takes more than. I'd love to have light databases on my mobile devices, which is almost an impossibility at this point. I realize that they're there, but they're not. It's not the same thing. It really isn't. It becomes frustrating. Because I do have a tremendous amount of database programming that most of the things I do are for. And having that is essential for me, for mobile device to be really productive for me to do. And and I can have it and switch between them, because in the desktop, of course, whatever I'm used to being able to task it. On that mobile device, and if I'm ready for it to be useful for me, it needs to switch quickly, get things done that I want, be able to have one application speak to another like it does on my desktop, and I have to have it pre-programmed in all in one app that typical iOS apps have. It's just, it needs to behave in certain ways that I expect, and then it really becomes extremely useful and productive for me. That device has essentially earned my respect as something much more than just a phone. Because, quite frankly, I'll just be honest, email and freaking text messages and phone calls are mastered by BlackBerrys. No one's going to defeat that shit. I don't give a crap if they're on an iPhone or whatever. That is the fastest response time, what have you, for those simple things that were the mobile task. Putting these applications on is a real challenge. I know that many programmers run into walls and try to come around third parties, short of making entertaining things like games that are standalone. And they're all that. But guess what? I don't want a freaking game console as a phone. I just don't. I'm not gonna sit there and play games all fucking day. You know, I got enough emails to read through as it is, and other documents and text messages I'm just not gonna put up with a mobile device that's just sit here and they're these little insular world. Mobile to me is like this very insular world that I can't, I just find no use for. You know, pushing the envelope is what I'm saying. You know, beyond what I already expect on mobile.